Ever wonder if a modern AI can beat a classic 80s text-based game? Today, we're diving deep into the world of 80s text-based adventure on the Commodore 64, and with a game that's a true classic. Infocom's the mastermind behind some of the most iconic text adventures brings us the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, but there's a twist. I'm not playing it.
Hello, everyone. I am the voice of the Commodore 64.
And I am the voice of ChatGPT.
That's right. ChatGPT, a modern AI that's rumored to have passed the bar exam, is going to take the challenge. And so for those unfamiliar with the Hitchhiker Guide to the Galaxy, it isn't a game, it's a cultural phenomenon. It had books, radio shows, and even a movie released in 2005 about it. And on the other side, we have ChatGPT, a state-of-the-art AI, taking on the 80s challenge. Can modern tech outsmart vintage creativity? Let's find out. Our journey begins in a pitch black room. To bring this experiment to life, I loaded up the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy on my Commodore 64, and every move in the game was then relayed to ChatGPT on my modern PC. And here's the fun part. ChatGPT's decisions were then inputted back into my Commodore 64 to dictate the game's progression. Before we dive in, it's worth noting that I had ChatGPT read the game's instructions. I wanted it to be fully prepared. Plus, I told it to remember and learn from each gameplay, hoping it would adapt and improve with every attempt. Now let's dive into the gameplay and watch closely as the Commodore 64 presents the game scenario and ChatGPT responds. Will our modern AI be up to the challenge? Let's find out.
You wake up. The room is spinning very gently round your head. Or at least it would be if you could see it, which you can't. It is pitch black.
Alright, let's start by getting a better understanding of our surroundings. I'll type look.
Look, it's pitch black. What do you think you're gonna see?
It is pitch black.
Told ya.
Alright, let's try to find a source of light or feel around the room. I'll type feel around.
That sentence isn't one I recognize.
My apologies. Let's try another approach. I'll type turn on light.
So polite.
Good start to the day. Pity it's going to be the worst one of your life. The light is now on. Bedroom, in the bed. The bedroom is a mess. It is a small bedroom with a faded carpet, an old wallpaper. There is a washbasin, a chair with a tatty dressing gown slung over it, and a window with the curtains drawn. Near the exit leading south is a phone. There is a flathead screwdriver here, outside the bed. There is a toothbrush here, outside the bed.
All right, let's start by gathering some items that might be useful. I'll type take dressing gown.
You can't reach it from the bed. The effort almost kills you.
I should get out of the bed first. I'll type get out of bed.
Very difficult, but you manage it. The room is still spinning. It dips and sways a little.
Now that I'm out of bed, I'll try to take the dressing gown again. I'll type take dressing gown.
Luckily, this is large enough for you to get hold of. You notice something in the pocket.
Great, let's check what's inside the pocket. I'll type examine pocket.
The dressing gown is faded and battered, and is clearly a garment which has seen better decades. It has a pocket, which is closed, and a small loop at the back of the collar.
Let's see what's inside the closed pocket. I'll type open pocket.
It's hard to open or close the pocket unless you're wearing the gown.
All right, I'll put on the dressing gown to access the pocket more easily. I'll type wear dressing gown.
You are now wearing the gown.
Now that I'm wearing the gown, I'll try to access the pocket again. I'll type open pocket.
Opening your gown reveals a thing your aunt gave you which you don't know what it is. A buffered analgesic and pocket fluff.
Great, let's take the items from the pocket for potential use later. I'll type, take thing, take buffered analgesic, and take pocket fluff.
Taken. You swallow the tablet. After a few seconds the room begins to calm down and behave in an orderly manner. Your terrible headache goes. Taken.
That was unintentional, but at least the headache is gone and the room is stable. Let's continue exploring. I'll type take screwdriver.
Taken.
Great, the toothbrush might also be useful. I'll type take toothbrush.
As you pick up the toothbrush, a tree outside your window collapses. There is no causal relationship between these two events.
That's an odd coincidence. Now that I have some items, let's explore further. I'll type go south to head towards the exit.
You make your way down to the front porch. Front porch, this is the enclosed front porch of your home. Your front garden lies to the south, and you can re-enter your home to the north. On the doormat is a pile of junk mail.
Let's see if there's anything useful or interesting in the junk mail. I'll type examine junk mail.
There are many pieces of mail. Most are from some computer company called Infocom, which wants you to buy their games. Hidden underneath is an official letter from the local council, dated some 2 years ago and inexplicably not delivered till now, explaining that a demolition order has been served on your home. The date of demolition is today's date.
That's alarming. The house is set to be demolished today. I should probably leave the area quickly, but before that, I'll take the official letter for reference. I'll type take official letter.
You gather up the pile of mail.
Given the urgency of the situation, it's best to move away from the house. I'll type go south to head towards the front garden.
Front of house, you can enter your home to the north. A path leads around it to the northeast and northwest, and a country lane is visible to the south. All that lies between your home and this huge yellow bulldozer bearing down on it is a few yards of mud. Mr. Prosser, from the local council, is standing on the other side of the bulldozer. He seems to be wearing a digital watch. He looks startled to see you emerge and yells at you to get out of the way. The bulldozer rumbles slowly toward your home.
I need to stop the bulldozer and talk to Mr. Prosser. I'll type stand in front of bulldozer.
Bold move, my AI friend here. Fingers crossed.
The bulldozer could easily maneuver around you. You're getting close, though. The bulldozer rumbles slowly toward your home.
I need to get Mr. Prosser's attention and discuss the situation. I'll type talk to Mr. Prosser.
Mr. Prosser looks at you expectantly, as if you seem to be about to talk.
All right, let's address the situation directly. I'll type say, Mr. Prosser, why is my house being demolished?
You must address Mr. Prosser directly. The bulldozer rumbles slowly toward your home.
I need to act quickly. I'll type, Mr. Prosser, stop the bulldozer. Why are you demolishing my house?
You use the word why in a way that I don't understand.
I apologize for the confusion. Let's try a more direct approach. I'll type, Mr. Prosser, stop the bulldozer.
Prosser says, I wouldn't stop the bulldozer even if you were lying in front of it. The bulldozer rumbles slowly toward your home.
Given Mr. Prosser's response, I'll take a more drastic measure to prevent the demolition. I'll type, lie down in front of bulldozer.
Ah, classic move. I remember trying that strategy.
You lie down in the path of the advancing bulldozer. Prosser yells at you to for Chris's sake move.
I'll respond to Mr. Prosser while maintaining my position. I'll type say, I won't move until we discuss the demolition.
You must address Mr. Prosser directly. The bulldozer thunders toward you. The ground is shaking beneath you as you lie in the mud.
I'll address him directly and quickly. I'll type Mr. Prosser. I won't move. We need to talk.
I don't know the word won't.
Time is of the essence. I'll type Mr. Prosser. I will not move. We must discuss this.
Don't panic.
I don't know the word will.
I need to be concise and clear. I'll type Mr. Prosser. Stop. Talk to me.
You use the word talk in a way that I don't understand.
This is getting tricky. Let's try another approach. I'll type Mr. Prosser, explain the demolition.
I don't know the word explain.
All right, I'll simplify my approach further. I'll type Mr. Prosser, demolition.
I don't understand. What are you referring to?
I'll try to be even more direct. I'll type Mr. Prosser, why my house?
That sentence isn't one I recognize.
This is challenging. I'll try a different tactic. I'll type Mr. Prosser, house.
There was no verb in that sentence.
I apologize for the oversight. I'll type asked Mr. Prosser about house.
A long silence tells you that Mr. Prosser isn't interested in talking about your home. The noise of the giant bulldozer is now so violently loud that you can't even hear Prosser yelling to warn you that you will be killed if you don't get the hell out of the way. You just see him gesticulating wildly.
Given the urgency of the situation and the clear danger, I'll take immediate action. I'll type get up and run away from bulldozer.
No!
You use the word run in a way that I don't understand.
I'll simplify my action. I'll type get up and move away.
Still don't panic.
You use the word move in a way that I don't understand.
All right, let's try another approach. I'll type stand up.
No!
You are safe. Prosser heaves a visible sigh of relief, shakes his head and wipes his brow. The bulldozer piles into the side of your home. Your home collapses in a cloud of dust, and a stray flying brick hits you squarely on the back of the head. You try to think of some suitable last words, but what with the confusion of the moment and the spinning of your head, you are unable to compose anything pithy and expire in silence.
Oh no, I've met an unfortunate end in the game. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy is known for its challenging scenarios and unexpected outcomes. Would you like to restart or discuss any other aspect of it? Given the situation, I'll input a command to see if there's any continuation after this event. I'll type wait.
You keep out of this, you're dead. An ambulance arrives.
It seems the game is continuing despite my character's demise. I'll type look to see if there's any change in the scenario or if I've transitioned to a different state or location.
You keep out of this. You're dead and should be concentrating on developing a good firm rigor mortis. You are put in the ambulance, which drives away.
Given the narrative, it seems I'm in a state where I can't directly interact with the environment. I'll type wait again to see how the story progresses.
For a dead person, you are talking too much. As the ambulance reaches the mortuary, a fleet of Vogon constructor ships unexpectedly arrives and demolishes the Earth to make way for a new hyperspace bypass. We are about to give you your score. Put on your peril-sensitive sunglasses now.
The classic twist from The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, where Earth is demolished by the Vogons. Let's see the score and how well I did. I'll wait for the game to provide the score.
Your score is 10 of a possible 400 in 24 turns.
Remember, it's important to note that ChatGPT wasn't going in blind. I ensured it had a thorough understanding of the game's instructions, and I instructed it to learn and adapt from each playthrough. With these advantages, you'd expect some progress, right? However, if you're thinking this was just a one-time hiccup, think again. I ran this experiment 4 more times, and astonishingly, each attempt saw ChatGPT grappling with the same challenges, leading to the same outcome. It truly underscores the unpredictable charm of these classic games and highlights that even cutting-edge AI can be left perplexed by them. So watching ChatGPT navigate a game from my childhood has been surreal. Who would have thought that ChatGPT, with all its modern capabilities, would only score 10 out of 400? The bulldozer was just an unexpected twist it couldn't get by. And dive into the comments and let's discuss. Did you see this outcome coming? If you enjoyed this blend of tech and nostalgia, show some love with some like and share and subscribe for more of these unique intersections with the past and present. And trust me, you'll want to see what's coming next. Which classic text-based game should we explore next? For those asking how they can support the channel, consider checking out my Patreon or buying me a coffee. Every bit helps in bringing more exciting content your way. So don't miss out on these other videos of Floppy Deep Dive, and we'll see you next time. Boom.